Hello, my goblin family, and welcome to the chaos. We are starting off strong here tonight with Doggo wanting to play with Tiny Kitten. They're starting to figure it out that the dog wants to play with them. But they're still not quite sure what to do with that and how to actually play, but they are interested. They like the idea. They just haven't quite figured out how that's supposed to work yet. Alright, so we're going to be working on Eevee some more tonight. And, yeah. But yeah, so this is how far we got last time. Yeah, we'll see how much more we can get done tonight. Hello, how are you doing, Michaela? Did you know Michaels is having Anchor Thread for 25 cents each? I did not. I actually have not used Anchor Thread. I use DMC. But for those of you who use Anchor, hey, apparently Michaels is having a sale on Anchor Thread for 25 cents each, which is awesome. Hello, window. We are on emotes only. Let me fix that for you. There you go. Conversation difficult? Yeah, probably. Especially with the community game, that would have been impossible. Pokemon community game, gods, please be nice to everyone tonight and let them catch the Pokemons that they want to catch. Thank you. That's all I got. Maybe it'll do something. Oh, really, sir? Oh my goodness, so while I was setting up, I accidentally ended up flinging my needle across the floor and then I couldn't find it again. And then I remembered that this thing that holds all my little bobbins for like whatever project I'm working on has like a really strong magnet on one end of it. So I literally was like wanding it across the floor trying to find the needle, and I did find it. So I was very happy that worked. Out with that. There we go. Okay. I'm like just mildly chaotic today. Like I legitimately only got back home like an hour and a half ago and like got home, like ate dinner, was trying to get my kids ready for bed and everything. I've been like out of the house all day today. Excuse me, sir. You're full chaos kitten tonight. You're just getting into all the trouble. Low budget metal detector, I like it. Yes. Not just metal detector, but it actually like, you know, sucked the needle to it and it made like just a little like clink noise and I was like, ah, yes, I found it. Wonderful. Right, where's my highlighter? There it is. Okay. Alright, I have to highlight because I actually didn't do any highlighting last time again. Because I don't learn lessons. Ooh, I need to put the soul dots back on Eevee's eyeballs because I think we decided that Eevee looked rather creepy with no soul. Her soulless baby. So I have to do that today too. Did I do... Okay, no. I didn't do that section yet. Okay. I did under the jaw, down here. And I did up and around the tail. And black. And then down onto the paws. Sorry, I'm catching up on all my highlighting. I'm sorry. It'll just be another minute, and then I'll go right back to stitching, I promise. Okay, and then we did these three little browns on the feet, and then we did this big brown patch. On Eevee's cool face. I'm doing like just the fastest highlight job. Like none of these squares are even filled in. They're just kind of streaked across. Okay. Oh, and then, okay. So then we did this portion. Right here, did we do that little spot by the eye? Yes, we did. Cool. And the one underneath, too. And the mouth. And yes. Okay. And we even did that one here. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Alright. Okay, so I have a question on here from Kindle Charlie. Is it difficult? I wanted to try it. So cross stitch is actually not super difficult. And all you need to get started with it is you just need the cloth and the DMC cloths and whatever colors that you need to work your pattern and a needle. And that's it as far as supplies go. And even like the patterns themselves, you can find them online for cheap and or free. So as far as like starting and trying out a new craft is concerned, like I know a lot of times there's like, you know, pretty high barrier to entry money wise, like to do some crafts, but cross stitching is actually pretty cost effective, to see if it's a craft that you like, and it's pretty easy to do as well. So if anyone would like to learn, I have a link in my bio for a how to cross stitch guide. And it gives you, you know, the step-by-steps of what you need to do to learn how to cross-stitch. and like, you know, what materials you're gonna need and stuff like that. So if you're interested in that, it is free and the link is in my bio. User of Big String of Numbers, thank you for the follow. I appreciate that. We need Eevee to have ice soon. This is getting out of hand. It's okay. Eevee can be soulless forever. It'll be fine. Hello, Turtle Mom. How you doing? Boop.
Boop me. I will boop you. Who do I have within reach? All I have is circle. And boop. Boop.
Boop. Hello, Kaley. How you doing? No, it was not meant to be heartless. It can't be a heartless. Why not? It'd be fun. I'm good, how are you? I'm good. It's been a long day, but I literally just drank one of those McDonald's caramel frappes, so I've got a little bit of caffeine in my system, which is not making me less tired, it's just making me a little jittery, so that's super fun. Eevee's too cute to be soulless. It's been a long day. It really has been a long day. I had to go to the dentist this morning, I know I went to the dentist last week too. Last week, I'm partially made out of coffee. I mean, I think I'm mostly tea at this point. I'm tired and ornery, so that's my life, is I'm just tired and ornery all the time. So last week I had to go to the dentist so that they could, do an exam basically and then decide what they're gonna do about my cracked tooth. And then today was the cleaning. And so they still didn't do anything about my tooth, but at least I went and got my teeth cleaned, which is good because I hadn't been able to go and do that for the last year or so. So I went and got my teeth cleaned, and despite the cracked tooth and despite some cavities that need some work, which I've known about. He actually said my dental hygiene is really good, is a lot better than he was expecting it to be, given how many cavities I have and things like that. I've been pretty open about my struggles with dental care on my TikTok, and I've talked about it in several videos about how I struggled for years to have good dental hygiene and take care of my teeth. And it led to, I'm gonna need some fillings and I'm gonna need, a root canal and a crown for the cracked tooth, and all of that. But, so it was just good today to get some validation that the last couple years that I've put in, trying to make changes for the better and to be even though I've done really badly in the past taking care of my teeth, doesn't mean I have to continue, and it doesn't mean that things can't get better. So that's where I'm at. It was kind of nice to get some validation from the dentist today, and the dentist was super sweet and really, really nice to me the whole time, and I'm a very anxious person. And how did I phrase it today? I'm a little particular about things. So, and he, was very nice and was just like, trust me, you are not my pickiest client. You are not my most particular client. This is nothing. And I was like, okay, cool, thank you. But also, I'm sorry. But anyway, so basically, all through my 20s, when I was undiagnosed autistic, undiagnosed ADHD, I spent most of my teens and 20s just feeling awful about how badly I took care of my teeth, but also not being able to do better because because I was undiagnosed, I wasn't looking for solutions. I was only looking at, this sucks so bad, I don't understand how other people can do it. And so I genuinely wasn't, like, I wasn't solution seeking. I was just living in the suck. And it wasn't until my current partner called me out on it, kinda. He basically sat me down one day and he was just like, okay, like, I need you to explain this to me. Why can't you brush your teeth? Like, why do you have such a hard time brushing your teeth? And I was like, I don't know. And he was just like, no, like, sit there, think about it, like, figure it out. Like, what is it that you're struggling with? And finally, I was able to just kind of, like, word vomit. I was just like, I can't stand. I can't, like, standing there in front of the sink for 2 minutes while you brush your teeth, like, that is hell for me. And he was just like, okay, so why don't you sit? And it broke my brain. Like, he legitimately broke my brain. And I just sat there in stunned silence, staring at him. And he was just like, did I say the wrong thing? And I was just like, no, it legitimately never occurred to me that if I am having trouble standing at the sink to brush my teeth, that I could sit while brushing my teeth. Like, it literally had never crossed my mind. Rocky and Bear, thank you for sharing the live. I appreciate that. Tiger and Plumber, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I'm doing a Disney Stitch Hawaiian skirt and guitar scene right now. Very nice. I'm assuming that, oh, Stitch. Yes, Stitch Hawaiian shirt and guitar scene right now. Very nice. I like it. So yeah, he completely broke my brain with being like, why don't you just sit while you brush your teeth? So I immediately went, sitting and brushing your teeth is a thing, what? Yes. You can walk around while you brush your teeth. You can sit while you brush your teeth. The rules are made up and the points don't matter. Drew Carey was not lying to us about that. Rocky and Gray, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. And Melba, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you too. So yeah, he broke my brain with that. So I literally, like, stopped what I was doing, went immediately to the bathroom and started brushing my teeth. And he, like, followed me in there. And after I was done brushing my teeth, he looked at me and he was like, okay, so, like, how was that? Did that fix the problem? And I was like, that fixed a problem. My next problem is that it tastes like mint, and the mint is burning my mouth. To which he, again, has an answer for me, and he goes, you know they make non-flavored toothpaste, right? And I was like, no, they don't. Like, what are you talking about? Everything in the store is mint. And he was like, well, you gotta order it online, but, like, they totally make non-flavored toothpaste and toothpaste that's in other flavors other than mint. And I was just like, we need to find this. So I did a bunch of research, and I ended up not going with a non-flavored toothpaste. I ended up going with a vanilla-flavored toothpaste, and I got the tooth tablets that you, like, chew on them before you, like, brush your teeth. Because I also don't like how foamy and, like, toothpaste gets. So, like, because he sat down and started asking me, like, these really pointed questions and was getting me to get to the heart of the little problems that I was having, for the last 2.5 years or so, I've actually been able to brush my teeth at least once a day. I'm brushing at night at least. Morning doesn't make sense to me though. I'm the same way. I still struggle to brush my teeth in the morning. I'll do it every once in a while, but for the most part, I forget in the morning. But at night, I'm doing much better, and I've been brushing my teeth every night. And so to have the dentist tell me today, like, yeah, your dental hygiene's actually pretty good, that was, like, really, really reassuring for me. And, like, I don't know, just really helped me today. There's iced peach tea toothpaste. Ooh, nice. I know there's like lemon flavored toothpaste and orange toothpaste and cinnamon toothpaste. Like there's so many different flavors out there. Like you do not need to settle for mint, especially if you're like me and it burns your mouth. Like it legitimately burns my mouth. It hurts. So when I was looking for like different flavors of toothpaste and stuff, I found different flavors of mouthwash also, because that's like another one. They're all mint flavored. They're not. You just got to go online. So I did end up choosing a non-flavored mouthwash, and it's like the tiniest little, the other thing that I don't like about mouthwash is that it's always like this huge amount, and like I can't hold that much liquid in my mouth and swish it around. Like this is uncomfortable. So the one that I found, it's like this tiny little amount and it tastes like water. Like it just, it has no flavor to it. So I've been using that and that's been really good. And so because he like sort of opened that door for me to look at the things that I struggle with as a series of tiny problems instead of like just this big overwhelming thing that I just can't handle. I've been able to start making accommodations for myself in little ways that are now helping me take care of myself and my space better. So, like, I mean, even like stupid little stuff, like, I don't know, like, it's not stupid if it works, right? But I don't know. Sometimes we just feel like we need permission. So, like Drew Carey says on Whose Line Is It Anyway, the rules are made up and the points don't matter. So, as adults, we were raised in these societies or these families who tell us like there is a quote unquote proper way to do stuff, and there's not. The proper way was made up for whatever reason. I currently settle for minty, but that's because it's free from the storehouse with our food order. I hate mouthwash because of Listerine. Well, yeah, exactly. Like, I don't like Listerine. I don't like Altoids. I don't like Listerine strips. Like, I don't like anything that's that minty. But yeah, the mouthwash that I switched to has no flavor. So I've been able to use it consistently. Dental floss, for the life of me, I can't use regular dental floss. My teeth shred it because my teeth are all too close together. I should have had braces when I was a kid and I didn't because we couldn't afford them. So my teeth are all like super jammed together. And so when I try and use dental floss, it just shreds the crap out of it. So I got the dental floss picks that are the tape, not the strings. So I switched over to those and now I can floss my teeth. I hate washing my face at night because I don't like water on my face. I don't like it dripping down my face. I don't like it dripping down my hands and my arms as I'm like trying to wash my face. Like there is no part about washing my face that I enjoy or that I like. So I started getting like face wipes, like disposable, throwaway, like compostable or whatever, just face wipes. And so I just like, it's already got the whatever on it and you just wipe your face down. And like, I don't wear makeup and stuff. So like, I don't really have to worry about like, if my face isn't like covered with makeup or anything like that, but like that makes it so much easier. And like, he's helped me make accommodations like that all through our house. He's amazing. He's like, okay, you have trouble with dishes. What is it? The water's too hot and I don't like touching the food, whether it's crunchy or slimy or oily or whatever the hell it is. I don't want to touch the food. So we went and got rubber gloves. Now the water doesn't burn my hands and I don't have to touch the bad textures. I don't know. I do. I'm a huge, huge proponent of making accommodations for yourself, but this is all like still fairly new to me in the last couple years because I didn't know you could do that. I can use the floss picks kind of, but only on the front teeth. It's harder to get them into the back teeth. But yeah, so So being able to needle magic, what is that? Is that a needle holder? It is. It's like a little magnetic needle minder for when I need to set it down. But it's shaped like a cute little spell book, so it says needle magic. But yeah, so that's, I don't know, that's, starting to think of it in terms of, like, this is impossible for me to do, and starting to think instead of, like, what is making this hard, or what is the most difficult thing about this, and how can I make that part easier or more manageable or less awful? cheers, window. There are armbands that catch the water similar to scrunchies. Yeah, a couple people had told me that too when I mentioned, that's awesome. Thank you, Eevee. Yes, it is a little Eevee. She's my fave. Aw, very nice. Yeah, there's like, that's the thing. Like, once you can identify what it is that you have the problem with, there's a ton of workarounds that people have already thought of. I'm just not always smart enough to think about them. But yeah, if you don't like the way that water, like, runs down your arms when you're washing their face, you're right. There are, like, these scrunchy things that are made of, like, towel material that, like, catch the water. So, like, you just put them on your wrists before you wash your face and it, like, catches the water and stuff like that. Cheers again. Kishao-kun, thank you for the finger heart. I appreciate that. Trying to break things down, figuring out where the actual difficulty is stemming from helps a lot. You do the dishes with the water running to avoid the squish nasties in the water. For me, I think the biggest thing that's helped with the dishes, honestly, was moving somewhere that had a dishwasher. That's helped the best out of anything. But I lived for years in places that didn't have a dishwasher, so we had to wash them by hand. So up until a few months ago, my dishwashing gloves were my saving grace. And then other things that I did when I had to wash the dishes are, like, I would play music and, like, you know, because, again, standing. So that was, like, one of the issues I had with brushing my teeth. It's another issue I have with, like, doing the dishes, too, is just standing for long periods of time in one spot is really, really painful for me. So I would, like, turn music on so I would kind of, like, dance around and stuff and not be standing perfectly still. And, like, singing would, like, help take my mind off of it, too. Commandeering my kids to come help dry the dishes as I wash them is also helpful, so I don't want to do it all myself. Got back just in time. Huzzah! Huzzah, Lumi! Welcome. Never know what kinds of skills I'll need to learn for cosplay. I mean, for sure. Also, you're the first person to get the pronunciation of my handle correctly for sure. Aw, thank you. I'm glad I got it right. A dishwasher been out of commission for like a year and a half. Oh, yeah. I've never had a dishwasher. You know what? We had one just for a few years when I was a kid. And then, like, when I moved out on my own, we didn't have one. And then when we had one for, like, 1 year in one apartment, and then none of our other apartments had one until a couple months ago when we moved across the country here. And our house now has one, and I'm so grateful. Like, it's so nice to not have to sit and do dishes every single night. Like, we still have to do, like, big things like pots and pans and stuff like that, but it's definitely, like, a much more manageable amount of dishes. This thread is, it's like all stuck in the back of it. Get out of there. Thank you. You don't belong. I've had this handle since like 04. I thought for a second I read that as since you were 4, and I was slightly concerned, and then I read it as since 04, which is a much more acceptable answer. Sapphire Ice, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. Lorraine, thank you for the rose, I appreciate that. And thank you for the follow as well. Where am I looking? Here we are. Oh, it's that special time of the evening where we have chaos. Hold on, 1 second. Gotta move the cameras. There's one. There's two. Okay. Are you guys ready for the chaos that's about to ensue? That Lumi has brought on all of you and mostly me. Okay. Oh, hello. Hello. It's pet treat time. One for Clover. Good girl. Okay, I have to close this one. Let me get the kitty treats. That was the doggy treat. Doggies go first because she's an old lady. Wednesday. Wednesday. You got to get out of the drawer, honey. It's over here. Okay. Give one to... Oh, August. Be a gentleman, sir. Wednesday. There you go, sweet girl. Okay, one each or else you guys attack me. One. Just one. Just one or else you attack me. Yes, I know. You need to sniff my... Did you just lick my finger? Thank you for that. I appreciate it. Are you going to come up here? Come here. Come get snuggle. Hi. Hi, Wednesday. She's like, nope, I want that drawer full of treats, please. All right. It's looking good. Aw, thank you. So cool. How many cats do you have? I have two kittens, and I have an old lady doggo. So Clover's the doggo, and then there's two kittens, a little black one and a little tuxedo, and the dog's white. Okay. Yay. Hello, chaos babies. Mwah. I love you. I love you, Clover. You can't sit in my lap. Now the dog wants to be in my lap. Okay. Okay. For 1 second. For 1 second. Hi. Okay. Hello. Yes, I know. You want to thank me for the treat and give me a kiss. Yes, I am aware. I know. Okay, and you're going to put your face right in the... Ow. Ow. Okay. Hi. Yes. Hello. Yeah, I know. You're very welcome. I know you love the treats. I know. They just make you... Thank you for the kiss. Thank you. Okay. Can we get back down now? Oh, here comes August. Oh, you've got your shirt... Your hand stuck in my shirt. That's rude. Ma'am, we are on camera. I have 4 old cats and 1 kitten. Aww. The kittens are the babies. They are about 8 months old. And the dog, she's about 10 and a half, something like that. Oh, hi. Yes, I know. Okay, down. Ow, you're scratching me. Thank you. All done. Thank you. Okay. Kaley redeemed finishing a Pokemon hoop. All right, so let's see what we've got. That's the wrong drawer. Why do I do that every time? I always open the wrong drawer. I'm gonna have to sit here. Okay, so we're gonna set aside Eevee for just a few moments while we finish off the back of another hoop. Who are we gonna finish tonight? We got a Wigglytuff on top. Should we do a Wigglytuff? Do a little pink thing? Didn't we just do a pink one? Who did we finish last time? We finished Oddish and Nidorina. Okay. Last time we finished Oddish and Nidorina, so this time we're gonna finish a Wigglytuff. Hey, get out of there. Oh, you got a toy. Okay, good. All right. Let's.
Hey, I'm gonna need this, miss, which means I need you off of it. Excuse me. Excuse me, please. Miss Wednesday, you need to get down, please. I need this. I need my lap desk.
Lumi, she won't get off. She's sitting on my lap desk under the desk because I gave her the treats. She wants more treats. Okay, so we're gonna move that. We have a Wigglytuff.
Let's get a hoop.
Only for 13 years old and kittens 1 year. Aww, that's so sweet. Okay. That. Oh, sorry. I totally ran into the camera. I apologize for that. I am super clumsy. Can we fit a Wigglytuff? Yes, Wigglytuff can totally fit in a 5-inch hoop. I'm gonna need to buy more hoops again, guys. I'm gonna have to start bulk ordering these. We finished off 2 hoops last time and like 4 the time before. I'm sewing descent. Yes, Lumi. You may not be cross-stitching, but you are sewing descent still. All right. Descent among the ranks. All right. Here we go. Flip right side up. I highly recommend doing this on a table and not on a lap desk. This makes it really hard to get the downward pressure. All right. Oh yeah. Wiggly tip. There we go. Okay, let's straighten that out just a little bit. There we go. Take your finger tight. All right. Ron Jamilia, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Same here. Yes. Looks good. Thank you. So one of the things, for those of you on TikTok, one of the things we do over on Twitch, so the people who are following me over on Twitch, is they are turning in rewards points for things like feeding the chaos some treats and stopping my stitching in order to finish up a hoop that I have already finished stitching but I haven't like hooped and framed yet, because I have so many of them and this is the part of the process that I hate the most and I never have any motivation to do it, so they force me to do it. Where are my scissors? Here they are. So, I re-hoop it. I make sure it's nice and centered in the frame. I make sure it's nice and tight. I've like gone all the way around the edge and made sure it's nice and tight all the way around. Do, 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 do. Nice and tight up there. And it should sound kind of like a drum. You don't want it to be like floppy in here. So you want it to be nice and tight. The bigger the hoop is, the harder it is to get it like nice and tightly in the frame. So like 7, 8, 9, 10 inch hoops are going to be a lot harder than like 4, 5, 6 inch hoops. Tim Anderson, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. And Jenny Lopez, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you too. Lorraine, thank you so much for the roses. I appreciate that. Weird hearing my name in English. I'm sorry if I mispronounced it. I tried. Dasher Queen, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is about an inch or so out all the way around the hoop. I'm going to be cutting this into just kind of a rough circle. It does not have to be exact by any means, but you just want about an inch or so all the way around. Do, 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 do. I finally remembered to move my trash can like right here next to me so I'm not like having to like do gymnastics to like throw the excess scrap away. Okay, so the next step is I'm gonna take the same pair of scissors and I'm gonna cut little tabs. I'm like gonna cut this extra edge into like little tabs all the way around. So we're literally just snipping straight from the edge to the wooden frame. About every inch or two around the edge. If it's a smaller hoop, I will make smaller tabs. If it is a larger hoop, I will make longer tabs. scissors can go away now. This is on my junk floss, so I'm going to pull a color out to stitch with. We're going to pick some pink for Wigglytuff. I'm legally blind, but would love to learn to cross-stitch. I love cross-stitching. I don't know that I have any tips for people who have a hard time seeing and things like that. Like, I mean, I wear glasses, but I have to wear glasses to read and stuff, but my eyes definitely aren't too bad. So, unfortunately, I'm not sure I have any, like, super tips for that. Let me think about it. But, I mean, cross-stitching is definitely not hard, but I would say, like, the biggest thing would be pick as low of a count of Ida cloth as you can get. So I stitch on 14 count, and that means that there's 14 stitches per inch, but they do make, like, 8 and 11 count, so there's only, like, 8 or 11 stitches per inch, so the holes are going to be a lot further apart. They're going to be a lot easier to see. So, like, I think that would be, like, my biggest thing would be definitely use a lower count of Ida cloth. They also make plastic, like, Ida cloth, like, hold on, I've got a piece of it. Somewhere, hold on. Because it looks slightly different. But it is still, like, you can still cross-stitch with it. Ow, hold on. I just banged my knee into the corner of my desk, and that was really, really painful. Ouchies. Okay. Okay, give me 1 second. I blame you. Okay, so it's like plastic. It's usually designed, it's made for, like, little kids, like, who are just learning how to cross stitch. So it has, like, really big holes in it. And usually you stitch with yarn instead of with, like, DMC floss, and you use, like, a big plastic needle or like a big tapestry needle instead. So that would make it a lot easier to, like, see. And, like, those big plastic needles, you're a lot less likely to poke yourself with them because, like, or, like, hurt yourself and poke yourself with them because they're just made out of plastic and they're pretty dull. But you can still do, like, cool patterns and stuff on that. You don't have to, like, stick with, like, the kids, like, it's a rainbow kit if you don't want to. Like, you can still, like, you know, get patterns off the internet for stuff that you want to do and then just, like, use, I can't think of what the heck the plastic stuff is called. Somebody help me. Like, I am struggling over here. Okay. Ah, the life of me. Plastic canvas. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Plastic canvas. All right, for the life of me, I'm struggling with the words tonight. I think it's, like, the caffeine this late at night with, like, also how tired I am. It's, like, a weird mix tonight. I'm full of chaos, like always, but just extra tonight. I have points burning a hole in my pocket tonight. Okay, hold on, hold on. The points. I am trying to create a new community challenge, and it's like not letting me right now. So I don't know what the heck the deal is, but I had an idea. So I've been working. I have the monster tapestry piece that I started. It is 5 feet wide by 6 feet tall on 14 count Ida cloth. So the same count as this. And it is all of the first five generations of Pokemon are on it. And it's gonna be massive. It's gonna take me years to do. But I thought that might be cool to do for a stream. So I was trying to like set that up to be like a community goal for you guys, and it like wasn't letting me. I sat and argued with it for like 5 minutes and then realized I was running late to my own stream. So there's that. But yeah. Oh my gosh, you guys are like gonna try and get me to just finish hoops all night. Just remember, these hurt my hands, so like I really can only do like a couple at a time, and I do need a break in between them. So please be nice. The goal is more than Fortnite team. We got that. Oh my goodness, you guys! I have 800 right now, so I should be able to. Oh my goodness! You guys are chaos. You guys are absolute chaos. Quiet Creations, thank you for the raid. Hello. We are being raided. Hello, hello, hello. I know you can't see it right now. We are stitching Eevee, but we're also finishing up a Wigglytuff right now. So I gotta finish the stitching. Fiery Diamond Painting, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. Bookmarks, yes, bookmarks too. Bloody Worm, thank you for sharing the live, I appreciate that. I made coasters with plastic canvas. Yeah, so you know what I'm talking about. I feel like that might be a good way to go. Bookmarks with the plastic. I'm awesome, thank you. I appreciate that. I am chaos incarnate. Hello, how are you? I am chaotic tonight, so I hope you enjoy the energy. I've had too much caffeine and not enough sleep. All right, window, cheers. Little Devil Ant, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. Oh. My eyes are watering now because I keep laughing. What's your TikTok? Seriously, Tink? my TikTok is Alphabet Soup. It's the same as on Twitch, except it's an O instead of a zero. And if you're on TikTok and you're going the other way, it's Alphabet Soup, but with a zero instead of an O. so yeah, it's just, you know, vice versa. It's not all about me, though. It's all about me. This is my show, right? That's how this works. Oh, was asking Lumi. I'm sorry, Tink. I thought you were talking to me. I don't know why. I should have known. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna tie this off. All right, so there is our Wigglytuff, all ready to be hung up on the wall. Got it. There we go. Now we're done. Okay, so now we can get back to cross-stitching Eevee. Self-centered mess. Hey, this is my show, Tink. This is my show. But also cheers, four times. One, 2. 3. And 4. Alright. Wandering Urchin, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. So I'm watching New Girl cross-stitching and watching you, and they're talking about dragons. I mean,
hey, I like the New Girl. That is one of my comfort shows.
They're talking about dragons. Very nice. We should always be talking about dragons. Black Fawn Originals, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Dinosaurs, it reminded me of the story of your kid. Ooh, what story about my kid? What story about my tiny chaos goblin? Stephanie Victoria, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. You only counted 2. I definitely counted 4, I think. I definitely counted 4. Just because you can't count, you can go back and watch the replay. We're gonna split this thread. It's a lot, and there's a character in this. Give me a second. Oh, that's okay. You missed one from window. No, I did 2 from window. I did 2 cheers from window and 4 from Tink. Was there a 3rd one from window? Now you have me second guessing. My sanity. Tink likes making me second guess my sanity because she thinks it's fun. But load the activity. Show me, show me, show me, show me, show me, show me, show me. All right, we got 2 from window about 25 minutes ago. The pet treat time from Lumi, finishing the Pokemon hoop from Kaley. We got a raid from Quiet Creations. Oh, we did get another hydrate from window. Okay, I think I missed one. If not, here's another hydrate for just for funsies then. Cheers to all of you. She cheats. I do not cheat. Lumi, thank you for the cheer. I just saw that. And Nellybird Creations, thank you for the follow. I just saw that too, because I can't... I like, miss stuff on this screen, so, like, I have to have this one up on the side to, like, keep track of what's happening when I... Just waiting 15 minutes till Kitty makes you finish home. Yeah, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna have to just be finishing all the hoops tonight. I've already accepted. I was sitting here, like, tonight I was like, ooh, maybe I'll have enough time to finish Eevee. I won't. I should know you all better. It's not gonna happen. Eevee's gonna take forever. Alright. Another cheers for Tink, and if you don't see this Tink, it's your fault, not mine. Sorry, little Eevee. You might have to wait for another few days to get finished. I was gonna put soul beans in its eyes, but apparently y'all want to make me do everything but stitch tonight, which is, you know, it's fine. It's fine. It'll be fine. Oh, my kid wanting to be a paleontologist because they want to find dragons. And Jess and Nick were talking about if dragons were dinosaurs the last part. Yes. Yes. Jess gets very upset that Nick thinks dragons and dinosaurs are basically the same thing. Yeah. And my kid, I had an entire argument with a 6-year-old, which, by the way, just don't have an argument with a 6-year-old. It's not worth your time and energy. But my 6-year-old wants to be a paleontologist. Because they want to find dragons. They basically think that the current paleontologists are not doing their job well enough. because all they've found so far are dinosaurs when clearly dragons exist. And I have suggested that perhaps pterosaurs are about as close as we're gonna get. That was deemed an unacceptable answer, Mom. How dare you? Dragons are real. How dare you? Because clearly they have read books about dragons, therefore they must exist. This kid is 6 years old and has devoured almost every single dragon book in the entire kids section of the library. Of several libraries, because we moved from California to Maryland, and they now have a new library to decimate the dragon section of. Ghost type Eevee. Eevee needs to remain soulless. Okay, I mean, I can leave Eevee soulless until the end. We can add the soul as like the very last step. We can do that. We can have a soulless Eevee for a while. I did it with Jigglypuff when I was stitching Jigglypuff, and let me tell you, it is very disconcerting at the end to have everything but the eyes done. Getting so close to finishing my Hummingbird with the Lotus, almost done on the Black Rabbit. Ooh, I remember seeing that one. That one's so pretty. I'm so excited to see it when it's done. Thank you for those of you who have been following me, and I just keep missing your thing. So I apologize for that, and I appreciate you. So I see Susan. I see you. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I had an argument that ended up with me going okay to the 7-year-old I was babysitting why I was so good at dance after having it a day. Yep. Sometimes it's just not worth the argument, and you're just like, okay, and just walk away. Just let it go. There is absolutely no logic in tiny humans, but like in the funniest possible way. Be right back. The embryo requires a sacrifice. I mean, yeah. No Soleon. Has kiddo read Wings of Fire? So the kiddo just finished book 5 of the Wings of Fire, and for a 6-year-old, like, those are some pretty big books. But yeah, they just finished reading the 5th one, and they have told me, can we please go back to the library next week, or like as soon as possible, because they want to look for the 6th book at the library. And we're trying to hold them off because we got them books 6 through 10 for their birthday in a couple weeks. But obviously we can't tell them that, so we don't want them to, like, go and get it from the library and, like, read it when, like, we literally already bought it, and we were hoping that it would take them, you know, another week to finish it, but no, they're reading, like, one Wings of Fire book each week, and then reading more books on top of it. They literally finished 3 Diary of a Pug books in a single day the other day, and then they're also reading Dragon Breath, and they finished like 2 of those in another day. Like, they're devouring books. And like, I know that like Diary of a Pug and Dragon's Breath are like not chaptered books or anything, so like it's not gonna take them that long to get through them, but like this kid is just freaking devouring anything they can get their hands on. It's insane. Okay, Vex. We got some cheers. Hold on. Open water. How many do we have? All right, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, 5. Oh, 6. Dang it. All right, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now there's 4 more now. Okay. 9 now. Oh my god. Okay, there's 5 more. Okay. Gotta breathe. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, I'm almost done with this. And if I have to pee in the middle of the stream, it's gonna be all your fault, guys. Holy moly,
6, my 10-year-old reads those. Yeah, we do homeschool, and our curriculum that we use is literature-based. So both of my kids were early readers and have been big readers. My goal was, like, my goal and what I always tell them is, like, I don't care what you read. Like, I legitimately, I don't care what level it's at. I don't care, like, I just want you to read. So, like, find the thing that you really enjoy reading about, and, like, let's get those types of books for you. And so that's why our library back in California was amazing. It had a huge children's section. So the kids were able to pick out a ton of books on a ton of topics and figure out what types of books they really love and enjoy. So my older kiddo, who just turned 9, really loves fantasy and magic, but like books that are big on like friendship at the same time. And the younger one, the 6-year-old who's about to turn 7, it just has to have dragons in it. That's it. That's all they care about. It just has to have dragons in it. That is the only. That's the only. My 8-year-old swears up and down she can't read, but she reads at a 4th grade level. Yeah, we were a little suspicious for a little bit. We were like, I don't know that they're actually like reading, like the little one. We weren't sure if the little one was actually reading, because they were going through books so fast, and we're like, oh, they're just like flipping the pages, or like they're skimming it and they're not reading it well. So as part of their homeschool curriculum, they, back in California, they were part of a charter school, and so we were able to get like access to the accelerated reader program where they can like take the tests, and they were getting 9s and 10s on all of the tests. And so it was like, okay, no, they really are reading these. And so we were just like, yeah, I don't care how difficult a book is, or like, you can pick as difficult a book as you want. Like, just enjoy it. Like, that was just our big thing. And they had a hard time switching from like the beginner reader and early chapter books up to like where they're at now. Like, The Wings of Fire is like an actual chapter book. And so they were like really, really nervous about switching away from books that had pictures, because they were like, this book is too big, it's got too many words on a page, like I can't do this. And I was like, and so I gently started encouraging them, like, how about like pick whatever books you want, and then we'll pick one big book while we're here. And if it's too much for you, it's the library. We're not buying it. We'll just bring it back next week. It's not a big deal. And if you get through your other books and you want to give it a try, then you'll have it and you can just give it a try. And if not, no big deal. And I can sit down and read it to you. And so I read them, I read both of them a couple of books that didn't really have any pictures in them and stuff. And so they were sitting there looking at the pages, and as they're like reading along with me, they're getting more confidence and realizing like, oh yeah, I can read all or most of these words by myself. But yeah, so it's been like, we've been trying really hard to keep reading like a positive experience for them, I guess. But the 6-year-old is reading at a 4th grade reading level. So that's like freaking awesome. Like, I couldn't believe it when they were taking the accelerated reader tests, and like they took a standardized test and that's what it came back as. I was blown away. From going at the beginning of the year being too scared to pick up a like actual chapter book to halfway through the year being at a 4th grade reading level, which is crazy. I always try to get the minis to ask for at least one or two books for gift giving holidays. Yeah, we always do at least one book for gift giving holidays, even if they haven't asked for one. We're like, we now that we know what genres they like, we were usually pretty good about like sussing out, you know, a book or two that we can get them. Alright, I see we've got finished another Pokemon Who, and I have severely neglected my TikTok friends, so give me a moment to get caught up on the comments on that side as well. I picked out my next project, Spring Stained Glass Banner. Ooh, that sounds really cool.
I saw some really pretty, like, stained glass looking cross-stitch patterns on Etsy recently, and I'm having to hide my wallet because I just want to work on all of the projects at once. More like die on the floor because he chose breastfeeding as a finisher after 30 minutes. Cross-stitch.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. Like, does that. Okay. Okay, there we go. I think we're caught up again. There we go. Cool. Alright, let me finish off this little section. And then we will finish another Pokemon hoop. I have all four seasons that I decided to do spring first. Ooh, very nice. Yeah, I found one that was like, it was like a stained glass piece. And it was like each, it was a temperature, it was like one of those temperature chart ones. So like each little segment, what you would like, you would stitch it whatever temperature, like stitch it in accordance to whatever temperature it was that day. And like, so like each circle was a different month, and then like it had like all the little segments within that month or whatever. And it was like, oh my gosh, it was so pretty. But I don't need another big piece. I will save it in my favorites for, you know, later. That sounds neat. Yeah, they showed like an example of like a finished one, and oh my gosh, it was just so pretty. Hold on. We have like two more little toe beans up here that are this color. This is actually the end of this color, so I'm just gonna finish going back the other direction, and then we'll pick out which Pokemon we're gonna finish up next. I bought like 6 patterns from Happy Little Mouse the other day. I'm so excited to start them. I am so happy for you. I love Happy Little Mouse's patterns. They are like, they're just so cute, and like they're so joyful. Like even the ones that are like skeletons and stuff, like there's just something about them that are just so joyful. Although I will say that the raccoon one is absolutely kicking my butt right now. I have had to do 2 major bouts of frogging. It was 100% my own fault. It has nothing to do with the pattern. I just sometimes can't count. But that said, like, it's super cute. I just can't count sometimes. And usually I'm stitching at the end of the day when I'm tired, which makes the counting harder. How many projects do you have going? Too many. So I always have a Pokemon going that I stitch live with you guys. I currently have another Pokemon that I'm working on that I am not stitching on the live, because my goal is to stitch all 150 of the originals and hang them up on the wall behind me. So if you're watching on Twitch, you can see the wall behind me. If you're watching on TikTok, you can see the wall behind me in some of my TikTok videos. So my goal is to stitch all of the original 150, which is part of why they're redeeming me finishing up hoops so that I can get them officially up on the wall. Because I've stitched about 80 or so of them so far. Maybe more. I've lost count, guys. I've like legit lost count. So getting some of those up on the wall. But, so, okay, so I have Eevee going, and I have Abra going, And then I have a giant tapestry piece that I started a few weeks ago that's 5 feet wide and 6 feet tall. That's gonna take years to do. I am working on the raccoon piece that is for my partner for his birthday in May. I have a backstitch piece that is like a Halloween piece. So like, I'm not actively working on that one right now, but I did start it. I haven't done anything on it since like Halloween, because it's not Halloween. So I'm not motivated to do a Halloween piece right now. But I like, technically I still have that going. And then I have a seasonal teapot series that I'm working on, and there's 8 of them because it goes by the wheel of the year. And so I'm working on the Mabon piece right now, which again, it's a fall piece, so I'm not like super motivated to finish it right now, but like it was fall when I started it. But all I have left to do is a little bit of backstitching and then I'll be done with it. So I think I have 6 active pieces right now. I think I have 6 that I'm working on right now. What is a backstitch piece? Let me see if I can reach it. Let me pull it out. I just grabbed the entire wad, so you get to see all of it. Okay. And this is what I mean when I say a backstitch piece. There is no crosses in it whatsoever. It's only backstitch. So backstitching only. But as you can see, like it's a very Halloween piece. It's like bat wings and frog legs and like it's, I'm just not in the mood for it right now because it's not fall. And then this is the one that like I just have like this little bit of friggin' backstitching left. Like I did most of the backstitching already. I just have a little bit more over here, and this one will be done, and that will make 5 out of the 8. Since Ostra was earlier this week, this is the finished Ostra piece for the Wheel of the Year. And so that's like, you know, like Easter vibes and bunnies and chicken eggs. And it's so pretty. And I have 3 others that I finished, and I have 3 more left to go once I finish the Mabon one. And then my partner said he would get them nicely framed for me so I can like hang them up on the wall. And stuff like that, and yeah. So, get off of my hand so I can put you away. But yeah, so those are some of the pieces that I like currently have working right now. Why is there? Sorry, that was like going away. Okay, before I forget, we are finishing another Pokemon hoop. Okay, lap disc into lap. Here we go. I'm gonna do the fox silhouette first for my partner because he likes foxes. Oh, very nice. I got the fox one as well. That's the one I'm gonna be doing after the raccoon because I like foxes. And so we're gonna hang the raccoon and the fox up like side by side. It's gonna be so cute. That's a lot. Sounds like me is reading multiple books. I also have multiple books going at the same time. I have a nonfiction book. Oh, I might have 2 nonfiction books right now. I am also reading Dash and Lily's Book of Dares, which I've seen the show. So now I'm reading the book. And then I'm also reading, what is it called? Moonlight Love and Witchcraft? Something like that? Sapphic poly fantasy with vampires and werewolves and witches, but it's also like modern. I don't know. I'm reading that one. And then what am I looking for? I'm finishing a Pokemon. I'm losing my mind. All right, let's pull. What do we got? What do we got on top? I got a Hitmonchan. I think we're hooping a Hitmonchan because that's what I got on top. We are not hooping a Mr. Mime. That is, don't want him on the wall. He is creepy. Will you fit? Is that the right size? I think that's the right size. I really need to get more 5-inch hoops. I'm like running out again. I had a question. Do you split your floss before putting it on the bobbin or just as you pull the floss off? I split it as I pull it off. I do not split it before I put it on the bobbin. that's too much work for me all at once. I need it, like, stuff needs to, like, I need to break up the tasks. Okay, good. I don't feel bad. I have about the same. Yeah, it's totally normal to have multiple pieces going at the same time. Don't worry about it. You have no swaggy. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I see sweet baby Eevee. Good evening. Good evening, Eevee fangirl. We are working on Eevee. As soon as I get this Hitmonchan in a hoop, I think, if he will stay. Will you stay, sir? Just go in your hoop. Just freaking heck. As I make the most awful faces, I apologize for those of you who are on Twitch. Oh my god. It's on there! Okay. I can't open this anymore or it's gonna... Ugh. Okay. That's not even centered! Okay. Try it around! Ah! Okay. I'll loosen that as much as I possibly can. Holy cow. Backstitching is my enemy too for some reason. I have no idea why. Sometimes I'm in the mood for it and I can handle it, and other times I'm just like, nope, not doing this today. So I just have to wait for like that backstitching mood to strike to finish that Mabon piece, honestly. It'll happen. It'll happen, and then I'll get it finished in like a day. And that'll be the end of it. Would you show other hoop finishes? What do you mean? This one, see how like close that is there? I'm not gonna be able to stitch this one, so this one's gonna get an E6000 finish. So if that's what you're talking about, I will be showing you right now. That's gonna be painful. Okay, I need to like pull it tight while pushing it down, but there's like no excess fabric here. This is an older one that I made before I knew quite as much about what I was doing. Some of these pieces that I'm hooping, by the way, are like up to 15 years old. And I've been stitching for over 20 years. So when I say like, hey, this is one of my older pieces, it could very well be over a decade old already. So like, you know, when I show off stuff like this and I'm like, hey, this is before I knew what the heck I was doing, I really do mean this is before I knew what the heck I was doing. I do not cut nearly as close to the edges as I used to. When I was young and poor and just learning how to cross stitch and like just getting really into it, and this was the craft that saved my life during those years, I would use as little fabric as I could possibly get away with. And I would use the E6000 method of finishing them off, because the fabric was the most expensive part of this craft. Oh shoot, I really need to get pliers. Okay, I'm gonna have to go get some pliers. I think I have some, but I know where they are. That Pokemon looks like an angry baby troll. I mean, you're not wrong. He kind of is an angry baby troll. Articom Proposito, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you, and I'm sorry I totally butchered your name. I'm so sorry. Any tips for beginners? I actually do have an entire How to Cross Stitch for Beginners guide linked in my bio. If you have any like specific questions, like tips for like some just like slightly more specific, otherwise I will babble on tangents. So tell me which direction you want my babbling to go in, and that helps. What got you into cross stitching? What made you fall in love? I started cross stitching when I was about 12 or so, 11, 12, something like that. And I was terrible at it. My first piece, I didn't follow the instructions. I had no idea that you were supposed to split your floss. So I was stitching with all six pieces, or all six strands. It was a stamped piece. It was a stamped piece, but you weren't supposed to, or it was printed. You weren't supposed to stitch all of it. You were just supposed to do like bits of it to like make certain parts of it pop. And then the rest of it was just like to be left alone. And I like tangled the thread so badly because like the lengths I was cutting were way too long. Like just start to finish, this piece was a mess and I hated it. And it was just so bad. I ended up having to throw it away. And I remember it was like rainforest with like parrots. And so that was the first time I ever cross-stitched. And I was just like, this sucks. And so then I started making friendship bracelets. And I did friendship bracelets for a really long time. And I learned how to do, like, the alpha patterns and, like, really fancy ones and, like, all kinds of stuff like that. And then sometime around, like, the beginning of high school, I was like, I want to learn how to cross-stitch, like, for real this time. And, like, actually, like, figure out what the heck I'm doing. And around the same time, I came across some Pokemon patterns. I am like the original Pokemon generation. I was 8 years old when it was introduced here in the United States. So I am like the core demographic for who Pokemon was marketed towards here. So for me, finding somebody who had made all of the like first two generations of Pokemon into cross stitches was like, I'm gonna stitch all of the first 150. And so I did that through high school. And then when I was in my 20s, I already had, you know, some floss and I already had some cloth. And so I was very, very poor. And so all through my 20s, I basically didn't finish off any pieces. I would stitch them. And then I would pull the hoop off and I would reuse the same, like I had like 1 4-inch hoop and 1 5-inch hoop and 1 6-inch hoop and 1 7-inch hoop. And I would reuse the hoops to just stitch more of them. So I was doing this with like as small of a budget as I possibly could. And so like if I had like a couple extra dollars, like at my paycheck, I would go out and buy like a couple new colors of floss because at the time they were only like 30 cents and now they're like 60 cents. So at the time I'd be like, I'd go in with like, you know, a quarter and a coupon and be like, I'm just getting one color of floss today. And the lady at the checkout was like, this is it. And I'm like, yeah, cause I'm fucking poor. And that was like kind of my little treat to myself was slowly building up, my stash. And then the person who made these Pokemon patterns took them all down and they're no longer available. And so I started making my own a few years ago and I started stitching my own. And so some of these older ones that I haven't finished hooping yet, these were made off of those old patterns from before that I never got around to hooping because I couldn't afford to buy a hoop and frame them at the time. So now that I'm older and I can, you know, buy some extra hoops and do that, this is kind of me reclaiming some of my 20s and like my poor girl phase. But all of the stuff you see me stitching live, these are actually my own patterns. So if you are interested in the Pokemon patterns and you want some, I make my own patterns now, and I sell them on my Etsy, or I also have my Patreon if you want access to like my whole library of patterns. I have about 36 of them made so far. I make at least 4 new ones every month. I actually released 5 this month and I'm gonna be releasing at least 5 next month too. Hint, hint to those of you who are in my Patreon. I'm also re-releasing a bunch of my patterns because I started making them a little bit differently and I like them better now. So like for those of you who a couple months ago saw me stitching an Eevee and you're like, this Eevee looks different. This is my new version of Eevee and I'm much happier with it. So I'll be re-releasing my patterns in the next couple of weeks as soon as I finish up making the last couple ones. I have a couple more to finish up. But yeah, so that's kind of how I got into it and how I fell in love with it and everything. It was just, you know, like, it's just my life. How long do these take? When I'm not stitching live, I can do about 150 to 200 stitches an hour. When I'm alive, it takes me longer because I stop stitching to babble and I stop to, like, finish hoops and stuff like that. So it takes me a little bit longer. Glaceon is the one that I just finished. It took me 4 lives to finish Glaceon, and I stitched for 3 hours each live. But again, I stop and I pause. So, I mean, I could say like, oh yeah, it took me 12 hours to do Glaceon. But that's probably not completely accurate. If I was stitching by myself and I wasn't live, I probably could have done Glaceon in like 8 or 9 hours. It really depends on the size of the piece and the size of the pattern. Like, Bulbasaur is itty bitty, but Charizard is massive. So obviously those are gonna take wildly different amounts of time to stitch. But yeah. Samantha Gatino, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. And Goat Girly, or Goat Girl Tori, thank you for the follow as well, I appreciate you too. My 15-year-old is slowly working on a stamped Eevee and Pikachu. Aw, that's super cute, I love it. I love when teens start doing stuff like this. Any recommendations on where to find patterns, especially gamer nerdy stuff? Definitely check out Etsy. If you're looking for Pokemon, check out my shop. Check out my Patreon. If you're looking for stuff outside of Pokemon, Etsy is fantastic. There are a ton of really great designers on there. I'm also thinking about branching out into doing like some Stardew Valley stuff and stuff like that. But I do keep my patterns to stuff that I'm particularly like... I'm careful about only making patterns for stuff that I am a part of the fandom. So you'll never see me making any Star Wars stuff because I'm not into Star Wars. But I am getting into Doctor Who. So you may see some Doctor Who inspired stuff at some point and stuff like that. But yeah. Do you make patterns with a program or like literally graph paper? So I do use a program, but I do hand make all of my patterns. So even though I'm using a program, some programs have like import features where you can like take a picture and import it and it will like guess and like do a decent-ish job of like converting it for you. I don't like that feature. It doesn't do as good of a job as I like. So it's decent. It does a much better job if you are looking to like take a photograph and make a really big cross stitch pattern out of it. But if you're doing stuff like this where like you're taking sprites or things that are already pixelated, it actually does a really bad job. So it very much, it's like largely varies on what you're trying to do. And because I'm taking images that were already pixel art to begin with and then converting them into cross stitch patterns, it's easier for me to just hand make them myself. And I like the way they turn out, and I get to hand pick the color palettes and things like that. So I like having a much more hands-on approach with my patterns. But I do use a program because it just makes it that much faster and easier for me. Two Bluefish, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I'm definitely going to need the Eevee one. Aww. Making sure I didn't miss anything. Sorry. All right, there we go. Okay, what was I gonna do? Okay, I need to snip and finish this. Okay, so this is another finishing, like back finishing method. It's not my favorite, and if you cross stitch at all, trust the process, and I promise it's gonna be okay. It's gonna look really, really scary, and you're gonna be like, oh my God, what is she doing? Just trust me, I am a professional. I have done this before. It's gonna be okay, but it is terrifying. Okay. So this is what I call the E6000 method or the super glue method. So that's all you need. Super glue and scissors and your hoop all hooped up and ready to go. Okay, so let's pull the scissors back out. So earlier in the stream, I did show off the sewn method. If you want to see that and you missed it, I will have the Twitch replay up on YouTube usually within about 24 to 48 hours or so. And I do have other episodes up where I've shown off that method before as well. Okay, trust me. It's gonna be okay. I know it's scary. Tracy Ann, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna cut this as close to the hoop as I possibly can. All the way around. Trust. It's okay. I promise. It's gonna be okay. But also there's no going back. So. Oh, the pliers. That's what I was like. I need to get up and go look for something. It's pliers. You're right. Thank you. I'm gonna have to go get those pliers. Trust the process. Okay. All right. We made it all the way around. We are going to throw that in the garbage. Okay. So I have snipped it pretty much as close as I can. I'm going to give it another go around and get all the little fuzzies snipped down as best I can. Okay. So you see how like there's a little tiny lip still sitting up? That's fine. That's part of it. It's going to be okay. I promise. Every time I do this, I always have someone in the comments being like, oh my god, what are you doing? And I'm like, it's okay, it's okay. So now I like preemptively like, it's okay guys, it's, I promise. Okay, all little fuzzies off to the side. I need to find my lint roller. I lost it in the move. I might need to get a new one. Okay, I'm gonna go run and grab the pliers real quick because I can't open this without them. So give me 1 second. I'm gonna knock stuff over, it's gonna happen. Okay, hold on. Oh, I want the glue.
Stay.
Okay. Pliers. Yes, the pliers were where they thought. The pliers were where I thought they were gonna be. Ha! Pliers.
Win.
Okay. Slide back into the lap desk. Without knocking things over. Hell, damn it. Yes. Oh, I'm sitting on the E6000. That is not the place for that to be. That's gonna end poorly. Oh, I just stuck it in all the fuzzies. That's okay. That's what the lint roller's for, if I can find it. Okay. Oops. Look at that. Oh, it comes off. Okay. Let's see if that is. Stuck. Alright. E6000. She was super, super blue. I never thought of using pliers, though. Yeah, the pliers are fantastic. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be putting the glue on the edge of this to keep it from unraveling, and also on the inside edge to glue the fabric to the hoop. This is a permanent hooping solution. You will not be able to remove it. So just be aware of that before you commit to this particular method. I don't recommend doing this method with hot glue, because hot glue remains very three-dimensional even after it dries, whereas E6000, as it dries, it actually like collapses and sinks against itself. God, this smells awful. And it will dry a lot flatter than it currently looks. And I'll see if I can find another piece that I finished like this to like kind of give you a side-by-side of the two. But if you were to do this with hot glue, it would remain really three-dimensional. And it would possibly push your piece out from the wall, or like it would finish weird. Like it's not ideal. So I definitely recommend E6000 is my glue of choice, even though it stinks to high heaven. If you are pregnant, don't use this. It's not good for you. If you're not pregnant, use it with caution. Use it in an open space. Don't do it in a basement at night like I do, where I can't open the window. I'll be fine. I'm gonna go stick this in the bathroom so I don't have to smell it. I will give the fur babies their treats, don't worry. I have to do one redemption at a time or else I lose track and I forget stuff. Okay. Pliers. The pliers, you know what? I'm just gonna put the pliers in the drawer with the scissors. Because I keep needing them and then having to bother my poor partner and be like, can you open this? But I found my own pliers this time. Okay. So hold on. Let me get up one more time. Okay. One of these has got to be finished with E6000. Who did I finish with E6000? I finished somebody with E6000 recently. Not recently, but here we go. Okay, so let's see if I can show this off. So, like, already that E6000 is starting to collapse in on itself and turn rather clear. So this is another one that was finished with E6000, like, years ago. And as you can see, like, it completely collapsed in. So none of this can fray, but like you can kind of see it, like it's not, the E6000 is not really three-dimensional like hot glue would be. So this can sit really, dang it, I touched it against the freaking fuzzies. So this still sits really, really flat against the wall, about the same distance out as one finished with a sewn back would sit. So side by side on the wall, nobody's gonna know which one was finished stone or with E6000. Where did you come from? You came from here. You don't have a home yet. And this needs to go in the bathroom because it stinks. Oh, I just dumped all the fuzzies on the ground. It's a good thing I needed to vacuum in here anyway. Okay. Okay. Oh, you saw my lap. I apologize. Okay. Shayla PBX, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I threw so much super glue away because I thought it was permanently sealed shut. Oh yeah, definitely try some pliers. Apparently you should make sure for proper airflow when using because vapors are harmful. Yes. Even though I'm in the basement, this is a really big room. This room is like, I don't know, like 20 by 12 or something like that. It's a really big room. So yes, they stink. There's plenty of airflow here. I just stick them in the bathroom overnight when I use the E6000 method, mostly because I don't want the kittens to, like, step in it. So I lock it in the bathroom for the night. And I'll retrieve Hitmonchan in the morning, and he won't stink anymore. It'll be all good. But yeah, make sure you get ventilation if you are doing super glue or E6000. Okay. All right. Back it up over here. Finish a Pokemon hoop. Da, 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 da. Four Moon series by Richard Amis has werewolves, fae, vamps, and the lead characters either bi or gay. I can't remember which. Nice. Love it. Sometimes the floss curls around itself. It like triggers me. I'm sorry. You could try doing floss drops if you don't like the way it curls around the bobbins. Do you remember your first Pokemon stitched? Ooh, who was the first one I would have stitched? I mean, honestly, it was probably Bulbasaur, but I have no idea. It was so long ago. Like, it legitimately could have been, like, anything. I have no idea. I know that the first one that I stitched off of a pattern that I made was this Vulpix, actually. This is the first one that I ever stitched off of a pattern that I made. And I do have a new Vulpix pattern coming out because some of these colors I'm not crazy about. And the pattern is like slightly minor differences. Vulpix, I actually did a pretty good job on that first pattern. I'm pretty happy with it. But because I am coming out with version 2 of all of the patterns, I will be coming out with a version 2 of the Vulpix as well. But yeah, I don't remember what the first Pokemon I ever stitched was. I was 7 as well when I got into Pokemon. I remember finding a Ponyta card and being so proud of it. Oh, that's amazing. I hate that this is it with confusion to seeing from CSRs. My first cross stitch was your Eevee pattern. Oh, that's awesome. All right, pet treat time. Here we go. All right, hold on. Cameras first, because otherwise there will be too much chaos. Oh, that's on the floor. They're gonna just step all over that. Okay, hold on. Camera's ready. I don't even know if this camera can like see very well, but hold on, here we go. Time for chaos. Oh god. Hi Wednesday. Hi. Okay, Clover. Clover first. What a good girl. Okay, Wednesday, you can't be in Wednesday. You can't be in the drawer. Okay, your treaties are over here. I got them in my hand. Okay. Hi. There you go, sweet girl. Ow, you don't need to use your claws, sir. That's it. That's all done. Aw, kissies, thank you. It's going back in the drawer. Back in the drawer. Back. You're just yanking. You are stuck over the cord. Are you seriously? She's stuck on the cord. She needs to... Okay, there we go. She needs to get herself off of it because... I'm not going to be super helpful. I'm just going to make it worse. All right. Wasn't as chaotic as the first time. I think we're gonna be okay. We're gonna survive. Maybe. Okay. Alright. What are we doing? Okay, we're gonna highlight the color that I just finished on Eevee, even though that was like an hour ago at this point or something. Okay. And then I know I'm not caught up on the chat yet. I'm pretty sure there is a hydrate that came through also. But also...
Okay, my dog is like bringing her blanket closer and closer and closer to me, and I think it's because she's waiting for more treats already. Like, she was way over there, and now she's like 2 feet away from me instead of like 10 feet away from me. So, I love Eevee. Aw, thank you. Making sure I didn't miss anything else. Okay. Absolute chaos. They really are. They are just the most chaotic. Okay. There is a hydrate. Cheers to Kaley. Okay. All right. There we go. Okay. We're caught up. We're caught up. We're caught up. Okay. But we finished a color, so that also means if you are over on TikTok, you get to participate in a poll. And the poll will be, which color should I stitch next? We have 5 colors left to pick from. So let me start that poll. You have 2.5 minutes to vote for 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. And it's Eevee, so there are shades of like dark brown to lighter brown to like cream colored. So, yeah. That's what we're doing. One cat is making biscuits on top of the dog who's wrapped in her blanket that she dragged over to me, and the other cat is just like crouched nearby, not sure what's going on. You never know what's going on, do you, sir? Wednesday, are you making biscuits on her? You are.
I can't with how cute they are. You're killing me.
Sour Peaches, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. And Little Jilly, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you too. So if you want to participate in the poll, there's like a little button down there and you can like click on it and vote for the color for me to stitch next. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I'm saying it again, just in case you just joined and you want to know what the heck's up and why I'm just sitting here holding some threads. That's why. And then we'll get back to stitching Eevee. Once I know what color you're going to make me stitch with. Do, 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 do. Clover, she just wants to snuggle you and make biscuits on you. Is that not okay? I don't think she thinks that's okay. I mean, I don't blame her. I mean, I like it when the kitties make biscuits on me. I think it's like the sweetest thing ever. She does not appreciate the love that they have for her. Grumpy old lady.
I still have tea. I forgot I had tea.
Yeah. My pup wants to play with the cats, and they're like, no, we old kitties, no like pup. You know what? Okay, so my old dog doesn't play. Like, she has never been a playful dog. She has never liked toys. Like, she wants nothing to do with any of them. And since we got the kittens, she's obsessed with the kittens and she wants them to play with her sometimes. Not all the time, but sometimes. And so because she didn't grow up like knowing how to like dog properly, she like can't play with other dogs because she growls and they think she's being aggressive, and really, that's her way of like trying to get them to play, but they get scared of her even though she's like 12 pounds. But the kittens don't know any better. So she growls at them and then they know that she wants to play, but like they also like can't figure out how to play with her, but they're trying. They're trying. So August will like roll over on his back and just kind of like bat at her, which is like not what she wants. She wants him to chase her, but he doesn't get it. But it's just, it's so sweet, like, watching them try to figure this out and, like, just not have any clue what they're doing, any of them. All right, so we had a tie between number 3 and number 5. Where are my ducky dice? I gotta go get the ducky dice of destiny. Hold on, I'll be back. So, when we have a tie, we roll.
Okay. The ducky dice.
Lynn over there? She's like sitting in the hallway, just chilling.
Okay. Let me sit. I need to not fall over. I'm gonna sit in this chair. Why is this so hard to get in and out of this chair? Every time. Okay. So, for those of you who don't know the Ducky Dice of Destiny, it's my little bathtub full of rubber ducky dice.
With little rubber duckies in them.
Because they're adorable. And they make me happy. We have odds and evens. So if we roll an odd number, we're going to go with this one. And if we roll an even number, we're going to go with that one. That's how we do this. Okay. Here's our flat surface. Oh my gosh. We rolled a nat 20. Can everyone see? Nobody can see that. The lighting is terrible. The lighting is absolutely terrible. That's a nat 20 on the ducky dice. Okay. So we're going to go with this one. Thank you, Ducky Dice. You have been lovely. Tiny Green Sloth, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Okay, I don't even know what color, or like what, not color. I don't know what symbol we're stitching. What are we stitching? The little equal sign. Here we go. Love the ducky dice. Thank you. I love the ducky dice too. They make me really happy. My partner got me for them for a present. I don't remember if it was for my birthday or for Christmas. I think it might have been for Christmas. A couple years ago. I used to collect rubber ducks when I was a teenager. And I had over 200 rubber ducks in my bedroom. And I still, to this day, have like rubber duck Christmas ornaments and stuff like that. Like fancy glass ones, not like a rubber duck with a Christmas ornament hook through it. Like legit Christmas, like actual Christmas ornaments, like blown glass in the shape of a rubber duck that my mom got me when I was a teenager and stuff like that. But yeah, so I used to collect rubber ducks and I don't have them anymore because when I moved out when I was in my early, when I was like 20, I couldn't take them with me and so I had to get rid of them. I kind of wish I still had them. Like, I feel like it'd be like a random cool thing to just like still have. But yeah, I had over 200 at one point and they were all unique. Funny story. I only ever had one duplicate out of all of the duckies that I ever collected. I only ever had one duplicate and my mom's dog, broke into my bedroom one day and stole one of my ducks and chewed it to pieces. And the duck that it stole was the duck that I had two of. It was the only duck that I had a duplicate of. And that was the duck that he broke into my room to steal and chew to pieces. So I still had a unique duck. I now had one regular one like that and one that had a big giant hole in it. but yeah. Queen, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Michaela, thank you for sharing the live. I appreciate that. Aw, Tess, thank you. You're so sweet. Magda Silva Cruz, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you too. Mine just has so much energy and both cats are 15 and 16, so I think it's too much for them. Yeah, probably. I think the kitten energy, like when the cats are playing with each other, she has no interest in playing with them. But when they're just like chilling, she's like, come on, let's play, come chase me. And they're like, I don't understand what's happening right now. But she tries very hard. She's very sweet when she's not being grumpy. Too much of this color, so we should be able to open up another poll in just a couple minutes when I'm done with this one. to vote on the next code. Question, do you ever feel like your fingernails get in the way? No, I've never really had an issue with that. Hey, there you are, I've been waiting for you. Hello, welcome. AMMT, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Juicy Pisari, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you too. I've just been bored. Don't know your live schedule. So I typically go live on Wednesdays and Sundays at 7:30 Eastern. So that is typically my live schedule. Occasionally you'll get a bonus day out of me depending on what's going on. In a couple weeks my kids will be going to visit their dad for a week, so I'll probably have some extra lives that week. And I do have an extra live coming up next week, but I won't be stitching. I will be pretending to be a gamer for a night. Because my Twitch followers redeemed a community reward of exactly that. Me pretending to be a gamer for a night and playing a video game and pretending I know what I'm doing. So I think I'm going to be playing Stardew Valley. And I will be doing that next week. But I'm not sure yet if I'm doing it on Friday or Saturday of next week, not this week. Because my partner Littlefish and I have been talking, and he might want to come play with me, so the two of us would be playing in the same world together, but he could only do it Saturday night, but if he's not going to join in, then we'll do it Friday. I'll do it Friday night, so we're still talking about which day, but yeah. So that'll be silly. I do not know that I probably won't be streaming that on TikTok though. That'll probably be Twitch exclusive for that night. Because when I try to stream me playing video games on TikTok, the screen tends to like, distort. Like it doesn't show up well. But yeah. Wolfish Inner World, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I like the cross stitch. I do too. That's definitely like my typical stuff is cross stitching. Oh man, those lighter colors don't like the cameras. I know. That's why I did so much of Sylveon off screen, because so much of Sylveon was like white and light. So it was like, I knew it was gonna be almost impossible for you guys to see me stitching. So I just did a bunch of it like not on stream. But yeah, luckily, like, I'm literally about to do the last three stitches in this color and then go back the other way. So luckily, there's not too much of this color. I wonder if...
Hold on. I've got an extra light on right here, and I wonder if... Does that make it any better to see? I don't think so. I don't think that made any difference whatsoever.
Oh, well. If you could be any mythological creature, what would it be? Ooh, what would I be? I feel like if I was gonna be a mythical creature, I wanna be something with wings. I don't know, maybe like a hippogriff or like a pegasus? Like I feel like if I was gonna be mythical, I'd wanna fly. I'm leaning towards a dark fae like Maleficent. Ooh, oh. Oh yeah, I'd be a fae. Oh yeah, absolutely. I'd be a fae. I don't know why, that didn't even like occur to me. I'm like, because fae are real. Like, it doesn't occur to me that those are, you know, mythical creatures. My brain, I swear. You weren't the only Sunday having live issues. Oh, I'm glad I wasn't the only one. I definitely thought that, like, it was something going on, like, on my end, I guess. So I guess it's good to know that, like, there were other lives that were having issues on Sundays. It means it was probably an issue with TikTok and not, like, my setup or something like that. I was a little bit worried, like, if I keep having issues, I'm gonna have to, like, figure something else out or something. So, okay, cool. Thank you for letting me know. Hello from Romania. Hello from Maryland. I love this for you. No, it was a global TikTok thing. Okay, cool. All right. I don't feel as worried about it now. I just be like, cool. It's a them issue, not a me issue. But humans that become fae end up as changelings and can't leave fae territory today. Well, okay. But like you asked if I could just be a mythical creature. So like, would I be a changeling or would I just be like fae? Like, am I human now and I'd be turning into this mythical creature, or like I would have been born as a mythical creature? But also, I don't think I'd be too mad about not being able to leave the fae territory, because have you looked around recently? Like, I think I'm okay with that. Like, fae, come take me. I'm cool with that. Shared my updated progress and my next project on Discord. Oh, nice. I'll have to check that out. Are you excited for the Pokemon reboot? There's a Pokemon reboot happening? I was unaware of this. I don't watch TV, so I like don't get news like normal people do. So unless somebody, like, I live under a rock a little bit. So until somebody tells me, I'm never aware that anything's happening. So if they're doing a Pokemon reboot, I want more information. I need to know more. Grumpy Shortcake, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. I just finished my first cross-stitch project and it was Vaporeon, and I love this. Aw, thank you. You basically be reborn or born as a fae. Oh, then yeah, I'll be fae. I'll take it. Alright. And that's it for that color. That was it. It was just that little tiny bit. They're doing the show with the new cast since Ash and the OGs are no longer. They're no longer? Huh. I'm excited to get some new cast. Like, I will say, I'm 20 years of Ash being 10 years old, I feel like we're ready for some new, you know? So I think I'm cool with them telling some new stories at this point. Oh, I also heard he finally won the Pokemon League and became a Pokemon Master or something, so I'm assuming that's probably why they finally let him, you know, become a Master or something. Something. Alright, we are gonna open up the poll again. This time, you're only gonna have 4 to choose from, because I just did the other one. Alright, here we go. As I attack this, that time wasn't my fault. The magnet is very strong and it attached itself to the boom. Okay, So if you're on TikTok and you want to click the little poll button down there, you will see what color should I stitch next? Number one, number two, number three, or number four. So we've got like a dark chocolatey brown and like a milk chocolatey brown and like a light brown and then like a cream color. But yeah, there we go. He did, but yeah, I don't think Ash's Pikachu is in the new one. Aw, a show without Pikachu? Maybe there will be a different Pikachu. Ooh, or Elderfey like one of the sisters in the Moon novels. Ooh, nice. Keeping Ash would be cool if they let Ash grow up. Yeah, I feel like Ash is ready to grow up. Ash is ready to be the next Professor Oak or like something. Like, Ash needs to be an adult now. He's had 20 years being 10 years old. Let's tell some new stories. Like, I like that the last couple games that they produced, they started branching out. Like Arceus was going back in time and you're building the first ever Pokedex. Like, I really liked the concept of that. I think that was really, really cool. Ooh, Ash being a gym leader or a Pokemon researcher or one of the Elite Four. Like, he could make like a one episode appearance as part of the Elite Four. And then with Violet and Scarlet, I liked the idea of there being like a Pokemon school. I think they went about it really weird of like, go out and find your treasure and you're just like, it was very like, come back for classes whenever you feel like it, but also go adventure. Like, I don't know, just the storyline seemed a little odd. But I liked the attempt. The attempt was there. I liked that they're finally trying to branch out and do something besides, oh my gosh, you're 10, get out of here, kid. Go be in the wild and hope you don't die. See you in a few months. You know, like, I'm glad they're trying, you know? Brock would be the new Oak, I would feel. I don't know that, but Brock doesn't want to research them. He wants to, like, breed them. So, like, I feel like that's, I don't know. I feel like that's possible. Okay. We have another tie. Yo. Okay. All right. 2 and 4. So we have, like, our milk chocolate color and our cream color. So this was our tie this time. And we're busting out the Ducky Dice of Fate. So, if you're new and you just joined and you don't know what the heck I'm talking about, these are the Ducky Dice of Fate. They live in a little bathtub, and they have little rubber duck inclusions in them because I like rubber ducks. All right, so how we do this is when I get a tie in the poll, I will roll the Ducky Dice of Fate. If we roll an odd, it'll be this one. If we roll an even, it'll be this one. So, milk chocolate is odds and cream is evens. So here we go, Ducky Dice, and that's a 6. Oh, sorry, I moved it so nobody could see it. That's a 6, I promise, which is another even. So here we go. So evens. Thank you, Milk Chocolate. We'll come back to you later, I'm sure. Okay, so this is our next color. Hey, you get out of here. Okay, there we go. Do-do-do. Brock hated being a gym leader. He definitely needs to focus on breeding. Yeah, he did not want to be a gym leader. And also, he had, like, I don't think it was just that he hated being a gym leader. I think it was also that, like, he had all of the responsibility of raising all of his younger siblings. He needed to be allowed to, like, go live his life and find his own dreams. And, like, That was like a big thing for him, was finally being able to like go and adventure and find out what he loved doing. And like, he loved making like special food for all the different breeds. Like, you know, he would make like food to help Vulpix's coat be all glossy and like food to help Geodude be all nice and strong and like stuff like that. So like, I could also see him being like running like the Pokemon Daycare Center or something like that, where like he could dote on all of the species like very specifically, like, or like a spa, high-end spa where he's like the chef and makes all the nice recipes and like they pamper them. Like, I could definitely see him getting into it. Is that Eevee from Pokemon? It is. Okay, what color are we stitching next? Okay, there's not too much of this down here, and then there's like a little bit up here in the tail. So we're gonna do the little bits down here first, and then we'll jump up to the tail. And this color cream is only slightly darker than that last one we were doing, so hopefully you can see it slightly better. That too, or work at a Pokemon Center. Yeah. That and he'd fall in love with every joy who walked through the doors. I feel like Brock needs to settle down. Like... Yeah, I was right. Yes, you are. Snow, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Not always Brock teams up with Nurse Joy. Absolutely. He has to team up with Nurse Joy. There's a Nurse Joy out there for him. I just know it. Annie Keepsakes, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Hey, Nicole, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you too. I'm sorry if I butchered your name. Okay. That's literally it for that color over there. Now we gotta jump up to the tail. That was it. It was like 4 stitches. I can see Brock with an Officer Jenny more. She'd keep him in check. I mean, maybe, but I feel like I feel like if he was with Officer Jenny, he'd have to have like a more active job. Like, but I don't know what. Didn't Misty like Ash? I don't remember. I feel like Misty did like Ash, but also, like, they were children, so, like, they may have grown out of it. And also, like, I didn't watch enough of the episodes to see, like, how much more they hinted at that, like, towards the end. And then, like, she, like, wasn't even in most of the recent shows. Like, she wasn't in Journeys, and she wasn't in the Alolan Islands and stuff like that. And the only reason I know that is because my kids watched it. I did not watch it. So I just caught, like, enough of it to be like, ah, yes, Ash is still 10 years old and still needing to go to school to learn about Pokemon. We're starting. Right here. There we go. Brock had an episode in Sun and Moon that he worked with Nurse Joy as an assistant. I could totally see him working with Nurse Joy as an assistant. Sweet Vanessa, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. He could be the in-house Pokemon caregiver for the police force. Okay. Yeah. And also, like, if they end up, like, taking anyone to jail, he would 100% take care of those people's Pokemon. Like... he would take care of Team Rocket's Pokemon when they landed in jail and stuff. Like, I could definitely see him being like, oh my gosh, are they mistreating you? I'm gonna pamper you! And, like, totally taking care of Ekans and Koffing. Like, he has no... he would not, like, discriminate against the Pokemon of anyone, you know? He'd be like, oh, you sweet baby, come here and let me take care of you. Alright, Chibi, we gotta finish another Pokemon hoop. Okay. Let me finish off this row real quick. And. Ah! There's one right there. Come on. Where are you? Go through the hole. There we go. There it is. Carolina, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Okay. We're gonna finish a Pokemon hoop. Okay. Ah! Eevee, we're gonna set you aside for a moment. Who are we finishing next? Who's on top? It's Bellplume! Alright, let's see if I might not have the right size hoop. I feel like I'm running out of 5-inch hoops, and that's like one of the most common ones that I use. That's a 4. Yeah, 4 is definitely not going to be big enough. Do I have any more marks? I might be out. People are running me out of my hoops. Ah, I have another 5. Are you the right size? There we go. So for those of you who are wondering how I like figure out what size hoop they go in, this is it. I make a guess, and I do make grids on the back of my fabric. So like when I make my grid, I go, yeah, that's probably going to go in about a 4-inch hoop because I know I don't stitch all the way to these corners. So as long as I can fit like all of the edges in there, I know it's probably about this size hoop is my eyeball when I'm first starting a piece. But I will always re-hoop at the end and double check and make sure, like, now that I'm done stitching this piece, should I make it in a smaller hoop? Does it need to be a bigger hoop? Things like that. I can eyeball it better because I'm going to be re-centering this. So when I first stitched this, I would have centered it here because I would have tried to center it off of the grid. But hold on, let me flip it over so you can kind of hold on. I need to open this. I can show you what I'm talking about a little bit better. So I'm making a guess. I'm making an educated guess. I never thought of making a grid on the back. That's so smart. I highly recommend grids on the back. If you like grids, it's pencil. It's pencil. You can't see it through the front. I grid all of my pieces. Yeah, the whole plume goes that direction. Do you keep your scraps and use them on other things? It depends. When I'm cutting pieces, if I end up with like a rectangle, I'll keep it for like to make bookmarks and stuff. But if I have like a little triangle piece of scrap, like you'll see, I'll end up with some triangles. I do throw those away usually. I used to save them to use as like stuffing in like other projects, but honestly, I don't do enough sewing of like pillows or stuffed animals or things like that to really justify it. And so I just have like a bunch of fabric scraps and stuff like that building up that I wasn't really using for anything. So I just decided for me personally to not do that anymore. But some people absolutely do. Okay, so let me kind of show you. So if I was centering this based on the grid, I would center it, I'm like trying to ignore the villa plume painted on there or stitched on there. Okay. So that is how I would center it. Let me put that on. And as you can see, like, that's not centered in the slightest. It is very much up towards that corner, and this has like a much bigger gapingness on this side, which is why I always, always, always recommend re-hooping after you finish your piece. So now I'm actually gonna like, and the reason for it is because we didn't get anywhere near this corner, but we got a lot closer to this corner down here. So we have to shift the hoop down just a little bit to make it look right. So that is essentially what we're gonna be doing, is just shifting that hoop down a little bit. And now, once I put this on, we should be close. Unless it shifted again as I flipped it over, because I do that frequently. Oh my gosh, go on, dang it. I recommend doing this standing up and not on a lap desk. Okay, so we're close. I need to pull it down just a little bit more that way, but we're close. Not too bad. Tighten just a little bit. Put down that way. Okay, there we go. Now we're gonna tighten going all the way around, trying to tighten pretty evenly. So I'm pulling up on the fabric and I'm pushing down on the inner hoop. So I'm like, fingers are down pushing on the inner hoop while I pull up on the fabric to get it tight. And I'm just going all the way around the circle doing that. And then when I get back up to the top, I'm gonna tighten a little bit more until it's about finger tight, and then I'm gonna do it again. SPGA, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Okay, so now I'm going to do it again. We're going to go around the circle again. I do this, I don't know, 2, 3, 4 times until it's nice and tight. Because as I do this, it actually kind of loosens a little bit. And, like, the fabric is stretching. Clover, I know that the baby's messing with you, but you don't have to bark at him. He doesn't understand. He just wants to play. Come here. Come here. Where's your toy, bud? Where's your springies? Leave the dog alone. I swear. The dog wants to play with the cat, and the cat doesn't know what to do. Now the cat wants to play with the dog, and the dog is like, no thank you, I'm sleeping. He's 2, I swear. Alright, so, there we go. Nice and tight. Should sound a little bit like a drum. I don't know, can you guys hear that? Like, can you hear that through the microphone? I don't even know. Sounds like a drum. Making sure it's good. I've seen people make magnets like them out of a word, flowers, or mushrooms. Aw, very nice. Okay. So, now what we're gonna do is flip it over. Doop. Please, where are my scissors? Scissors. I'm gonna go around the edge of the hoop and I'm gonna cut like a real loose circle all the way around. And as you can see, like, this side and this side, like, unraveled. This is probably an older piece, and it's just unraveled over time. Like, even right now, like, there's another piece unraveling from it. Like I was saying earlier, some of these pieces that I've made are upwards of 15 years old. So, sometime in the last decade and a half, I stitched this. And I'm just, dropped it. And I'm just now finishing it off. So I can go up on my wall, finally. And I have a lot of little fuzzies. That's okay. Clover, you don't need to be rude about it. All these little fuzzies, there we go. Ah, fuzzies. Okay. So yeah, I don't bother keeping like these little triangle scraps. I'm sure that I could find a use for them, but like honestly, I have so many projects that I want to do or that are in the queue. I'm in the middle of 6 projects currently, like, you know, actively working on them. Oh, I need the scissors still. I wasn't done with those. Window, you guys can't hear the drum, but the TikTok can hear the drum at least. I can't save anything else. I can only save the things that I'm actively working on. So the next step, now that I kind of have like this 1-inch circle around the edge, is I'm gonna go around. Okay, Clover, you don't need to be rude. He doesn't understand. Because that's the same noise you make when you want to play with him. Because you don't understand, the two of you, I swear. Between the dog and the cat, there's only 2 brain cells. And I think the other cat stole them both. Alright, so I'm making these snips, going all the way around to make like these little tabbies. And these little tabbies are going to be what we sew shut on the back. To hold the piece in. And finish it off. Now I can put the scissors away. There we go. All right. Let's pull out the bag of junk thread and pick a color. It's like a massive gallon Ziploc bag full of thread. Maybe some red? Maybe some red. Let's go with some red. I'm going to split this. Usually when you're cross-stitching, you cross-stitch with 2 strands of floss because there's 6 strands. So you'll cross-stitch with 2. When I am sewing up the backs of these, I want 3 strands of floss because it's a little bit sturdier. I'm sure you'd be fine with two. I just prefer three. Because I do pull pretty hard to tighten this as I'm stitching around. You'll kind of see what I mean as I go. So the three strands is just, it's a little stronger and a little less likely to snap on me as I'm stitching around. And I have had that happen before. Not too often, but it does happen sometimes where I'll be stitching the back up and it'll snap on me. So I prefer to use three, so it's less likely to happen. I need my needle. Thank you, Eevee. So I'm gonna thread this. There we go. Alright, so starting at the top of the hoop, I'm going to fold down the first and second tabs so that they lay on top of each other. And then I'm gonna take the needle and starting on underneath them, I'm gonna come up through both layers from the bottom. Pull it tight. Now I'm gonna take tabs 2 and 3 and I'm gonna lay 3 on top of 2 just the same way. And instead of going up, this time I'm gonna go down. Pull it nice and tight. This is what I mean. So I'm pulling pretty darn tight to keep this. They'll start to like lay down all the way around as I do this. So now I'm gonna put tab 4 on top of tab 3. And once again, I'm gonna go up. So I'm gonna switch off going up and down through each of the sets of tabs as we go around. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I'm gonna put tab 5 on top of 4. And we're gonna go down again through both layers. Thread's trying to jump through the hole before it's turned. There we go. Next one, we're gonna go up. And back down. Me human being, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. And up again. These ones. So as you can see, like, it kind of loosens and they kind of, like, start to sit up. And as I pull, they, like, bow down towards the center. So that's why I like to have the three strands, because I am pulling, you know, pretty decently hard to get it to do that. Sharon, darling, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. All right. And I'm wanting to make sure I pull really nice and tight after each and every stitch. If you wait until the end and keep it loose and then pull it tight all at once, it may not like pull tight evenly across it, or you'll like be more likely for the thread to snap if you wait until the end. So I, after each and every stitch, I do give it a tug to make sure it's staying decently tight. So these ones at the beginning, they're actually not like flexing as much. It's just these ones like close to where I'm stitching that are kind of flexing and bowing each time. Cat's knocking stuff over. Luckily it's nothing breakable. I think he knocked my kid's book off the desk. It'll be fine. Okay, so these ones, the tabs like barely are like overlapping. So what I'm gonna do is, as I come up, I'm actually gonna go through one at a time. I'm gonna go through that one first going up, and then I'm gonna go through that one second going up, so that they'll still sit down. But as you can see, they're not perfectly lined up, and that's okay. But that's what you have to do if you don't have quite enough room all the way around. I prefer to layer them up and stitch on top of them, like stitch through both layers at once, but sometimes you just can't do that if they don't overlap enough. You'll be too close to like the edge, and you don't want to catch the edge and have that tab like missed and not get held down at all. Equismart Massage, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Mama Lolo, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you. And Leah Slice, thank you for the follow. And Persican, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you too. You guys are amazing. That's the best thing a cat is for. I mean, yeah, just knocking stuff over. They've reached that age, finally, They didn't do it as kittens, but now they're like 8 months old. And they're like, ooh, I can play with gravity. I'd prefer you didn't, sir.
Sir, what do you even have? I can't...
Oh, he's got a bookmark. He's got one of my kids' bookmarks. Luckily, we are a house of books, so we have about a million bookmarks, so I'm not super worried about it. And also, like, it's not made out of anything he's going to injure himself with. But he is going to bat it around the floor for a while, so...
It makes him happy, I guess.
Alright, so, pulling it nice and tight, we are going to do at least a double knot, sometimes a triple knot, depending on how I'm feeling. We're going to do a triple knot right now. We want to make sure that stays nice and tight on there. Give the end a snip. And there we go. Now we have a villa plume ready to hang up on the wall. And the cool thing about the sewn method, so when you sew the backs like this, you can actually take this outer ring off if you want to. Like, you don't have to keep it on. Now, I like to keep it on, personally, and I actually use this little hook at the top to hang, like, to, as I drop it. When I put, like, I hang it on a nail, like, on through that. But some people like to switch this and have it down at the bottom, or they like to, like, take the outer ring off completely. It's definitely personal preference. I leave them in the hoops, outer and inner rings of the hoops. That's my preference. So that means we finished three tonight. So I've got Villaplume, I've got Wigglytuff, and Hitmonchan has been banished to the bathroom because he smells like E6000 because I didn't have enough excess fabric on one side to stitch. So I had to super glue him into his frame, and he's been banished to the bathroom for the night. So he can return tomorrow. Once he is not so sneaky. But with that being said, we're gonna come back to Eevee and we'll keep stitching. We almost hit a deer, sorry, it's weird. Oh my gosh, I hope you're okay. I'm glad that you didn't actually hit a deer. I'm assuming that that's the implication is that you didn't actually hit a deer. So that would be good to not hit a deer. Zebra Breakdowns, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. And Tasha Masha Pisha Pasha, thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you too. John D, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you as well. You guys are amazing. What did I do with my pattern? I set it somewhere. I think I set it on the ground. Okay. Oh, here it is. Perfect. Shower time, then bed, night out. Night window. Have a good evening. Is it actually okay? 10:10. We got about 20 more minutes for me. Then I'm gonna have to go to bed. I have to be up early enough to teach 10 kids. Hello, Miss Rose. How are you doing? You're still live? I am for about 20 more minutes or so. Unless my clock is running again. But I don't think it is.
It was a pokeball.
What time does the clock say? 10-ish. Close enough. You playing with the bookmark too now, Miss Wednesday? That's correct. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Usually go live from about 7:30 until about 10:30. It's usually my, like, oh shoot, I need to go get into bed time of the evening. I have to brush my teeth. Be the responsible adult. Not stay up until 2 o'clock in the morning, even though I really want to. I will say, oh man, this summer when my kids go back to California to visit their dad for a few weeks, you will probably get all kinds of weird, crazy time frames of me doing lives and stuff, because I won't have to wake up and take care of tiny humans or teach tiny humans in the morning. It'll be glorious. Hello, Tink. Glad to see you're still here, and cheers twice. Here's number one, and here's number two. Mason Dano, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. I absolutely did not miss Tink. You can watch the replay, but I promise. Trickster. I may be Faye, but you're the one who gave me your name. It's your fault, not mine. Chantel, thank you for the follow. I appreciate y'all. Finally found my people. Aw, thank you. I'm so glad I'm your people. Shalia, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Daniela Plaza, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you too. Your stitches are so perfect. Thank you. I appreciate that. Miss Kitten Kiss, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Okay. Why does this black fuzzy want to keep coming through here? Stab it! Stay on the back. Shalia, thank you for the follow over on Twitch as well. I appreciate that too. Did you watch the TikTok I sent you earlier? Honey, I've been on live stream for like 2.5 hours. When did you think, did you send it to me like earlier today? If so, yes. Oh, the one about masking. I watched that one. Yes. Sorry. My brain's catching up, I swear. It takes me a moment to process. Yes, I did. And sirens, yes. Faye and sirens. Not the masking. Faye and the sirens. Maybe? Hello, found you. Hello. Sharon, darling, thank you for the rose. I appreciate that. No, it doesn't want it. I know, the little black fluffy piece keeps wanting to hang out on the front. It has to stay on the back. It's on TikTok Afterlife. Okay. I'll check it out after. Over at TikTok. Very nice. So for those of you who are on one platform versus the other, there are pros and cons to either following or watching my lives on one platform versus the other. I recognize that some people have a preference for either TikTok Lives or Twitch. So I try to like have some things be like have something extra for each of the platforms. So on Twitch, because you have access to like channel points and rewards and things like that, you can redeem them for things like making me drink water, having me give the pets a treat, finishing a Pokemon hoop, things like that. But if you're on TikTok, you get to vote in the polls for which color I'm gonna stitch next, and when I finish a piece, which Pokemon I'm gonna stitch next, and things like that. So I kind of try to like give everybody a little bit of something interactive to do, regardless of which platform you prefer to watch from, because I do stream on both of them at the same time. So that way, even if you have a preference for one or the other, you still get a little something for hanging out, spending time with me. So I apologize to those of you over on Twitch. You don't get the poll, mostly because the poll feature on Twitch hates me, and the button refuses to show up half the time. I've tried doing it in the past where like I ran polls on both at the same time, and literally the poll button just decided it didn't want to show up anymore, and like I literally like I couldn't click on it because it wasn't there. It was just like, nope, no polls for you, and I was just like, oh, okay, cool, thanks. So I gave up fighting with Twitch over it, and now it's just a TikTok thing. Cheers, Tink. I'm a fellow stitcher myself, not Pokemon though. Aw, that's nice. I love finding fellow stitchers in the wild. None of my friends really cross-stitch. Like, a few of them know how to, but like, it's not their craft of choice. So it's just been really, really nice to like have a community on TikTok and Twitch and Discord. If you like Discord, we have a public Discord server, and then I have a patrons only Discord server. The public Discord server, we do have like a whole craft section. So like, even if you don't stitch, there's like other crafts and stuff like that. We play TTRPGs. We run like a self-care challenge every month. Like, it's a lot of really cool stuff over there. But yeah, it's, you can definitely like share your works in progress and your finished pieces, and we like cheer each other on. It's like, it's really nice to like have other people to talk to. Like, even when like I had to do like 2 hours of frogging the other day, and I was like, no, I spent so much time and now I had to undo it all. And people were like, oh my God, that's the worst. Like, having someone to just kind of like lament with you and like, and then also like cheer you on when you finish a piece is, I don't know. It's really nice. It's been really, really cool, like, having a community. Alright, we are gonna tie this off. And that is it for that color. So, snip. Alright. I've returned. Hello, Lumi. Welcome back. I hope the tiny bean has given you a break now. Alright, we're gonna do some quick highlighting of the bits I just stitched. There's like four little stitches down here. And that's it for that color. So if you were over on TikTok, that means we're gonna open up the poll one more time tonight. And what did I just do? I don't know what I did. I hit a button. Okay. Alright, you have 2.5 minutes for the poll. Can you start? Are you going to start the poll? There it goes. Okay. So, it's going to say, hey, what color should I stitch next? And these are your options. 1, 2, or 3. We've got, like, a dark chocolatey brown and a milk chocolatey brown and like a chocolate milk color. I'm like, it's all chocolate. Can you tell I want chocolate? I should get some chocolate. anyway, so these are numbers 1, 2, and 3. So 1, 2, and 3 for your poll. If you're on Twitch, I'm sorry. We can just hang out. I'm not the water bearer. I bring chaos treats. She limits the chaos treats, though. I do. I have to limit the chaos treats because she's stalking towards me. She heard the word treats. No, Wednesday. Oh, now she's going to just torment the dog instead. Okay. Because my partner, Littlefish, told me that I'm not allowed to just give them unlimited treats. So I do have to limit the chaos treats. The tiny goblin almost killed me, but I survived. No, no tiny goblin, no killing. Treats and hoops. 4, 44, 4, 4, 4. No, Tink, because you're mean and evil. It's not me. Oh, we've got a pet treat time. Okay, as soon as the poll's closed, we've got our last pet treat time of the night. This will be number 3 for the night, so we have to cut them off after 3. They get too aggressive. And also, it's like almost bedtime. We've got 10 minutes left. So, no, I wasn't driving. Okay, good. I'm glad you weren't driving. Meeks Miego, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Lalo Limo Tivadora, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. You're wonderful. Shy Guy, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you too. Del Sir, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Yeah, definitely still scary. I'm like terrified of crashing into a deer. That is like, I moved from Orange County where we don't have deer to Maryland where there are deer in our backyard like on a weekly basis. I'm terrified of crashing into a deer. Okay, so that's gonna be our last color that we have voted for the night. But I actually don't think I'm gonna get a chance to stitch it, but you did get to vote on it, so there's that. Just the two of us. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Oh my God, where'd you get that bobbin holder? I got that bobbin holder on Etsy. And everyone who asked about the needle minder last time, I gave you the wrong Etsy shop. I definitely said that this was from Modern Hoopla, and it's not. This is from Hoops and More. This is from Modern Hoopla. So yeah, this bobbin holder, I love it. It holds 12 bobbins, and it has like a really strong magnet on the side. I like keep accidentally attaching it to the boom arm holding the camera, but it's perfect for like my working threads for whatever project I'm working on. I just like throw some threads in there and I'm good to go, and I don't have to like sort through them. Okay, we've got Sarah, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. Okay, I'm gonna set that aside for a moment. We've got chaos to ensue thanks to Lumi. Okay. Are we ready? Are we ready for the chaos? Here we go. There's one. There's two cameras. All right. Actually, this is perfect because this is the last dog treat. I need to refill this. Clover! Come here. You want treats? Oh, there you go, baby. She's like, I'm going to take my treat and run away. Okay. I need to leave that out for a minute. See if I remember. Okay. Where are the babies? I see one baby. Oh, she went sliding across the floor. This isn't for you, Clover. Where are my babies? There's my August bear. Such a gentleman. No nails. Ow! One bite. You guys get... Okay, you know what? You two get... You can have one more. Ow! Those are nails. This is why I don't do two, because you guys get too aggressive. Yep, I got claws in my finger. That hurt. See, this is why we just keep it to one. Okay, now you can sniff my... No, I don't have any more. I know, I don't have any more. I know, they're like, come here, like, I need all of them, every time. That was it for the night, little miss. Okay. There we go. Camera back where it's supposed to go-ish. There we go. There's our soulless Eevee, still doesn't have eyeballs. I was supposed to do that tonight. And then they decided they want a soulless Eevee until the last minute. So we have soulless Eevee. Ow, that really hurt August, my dude. I've only done cross stitch with printed patterns on the fabric. I want to learn counting cross. Oh, you definitely should. If you want to learn counting cross, I have a how-to guide in my bio. And I talk about how I do grids on the back. Not everybody does it, and you definitely don't have to, but I talk through like the method of like how to do that and stuff like that. So if you want to learn how to do counted cross, great place to start. Fiber Art Frenzy, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you. Can we also get Elle to 8k before she ends the night with us? You did, I'm at 8.2 likes. Thank you, Tess. That's so sweet. But the Eevee Evos give me life. Oh, yes, yay. I've stitched Leafeon and Glaceon in my version 2 patterns. I've also stitched Sylveon in version 1. And I have several other ones up on my wall. Oh, Flareon is version 1 as well. The Jolteon and Vaporeon that are on my wall are from another artist who took all of their patterns down. But yeah, I've got a whole bunch on the wall behind me. If you're on Twitch, you can like see my whole Pokemon hoop wall. But anyway, it is the end of the night, so I'm going to be wrapping up and doing my end of the night stuff. I want to start by saying thank you so much for coming and hanging out with me tonight. I also want to give a shout out to my patrons, whose support means that I get to continue doing this, and I love it so much. This is, like, the best job in the world to get to, like, stitch and, like, make patterns for you all, and, like, it just, it fills my cup so much. So thank you all very much. And a special thanks to my patrons, Sarah, Allison C, Melanie M, Giordan L, Kaley H, Alexandra H, Chelsea L, Shirley L, Lynn Belizzi, Lynn B, sorry, I like read the whole name. Sorry, I need to make a list with just the initial. Amber C, Lisa K, Demented Lemming, AKA Avril. Thank you guys so much for continuing to support me. Your support means the absolute world to me. So if you are new to cross-stitching or you would like to learn how to cross-stitch, I do have a link to that in my bio. If you are on Twitch and you're like, link in bio, what the heck are you talking about? This is the link. Let me post it. There it is. That's the link in my bio that I'm talking about. You can click that link and find all of the stuff that I'm about to talk to you about. If you're over on TikTok, you just follow the link through, go through to my bio and click the link and it'll bring up like all the stuff I'm about to tell you about. So if you would like to learn how to cross stitch, I have a how-to guide linked in there that you can click on. It'll walk you through the steps on how to learn how to cross stitch and how to do your first cross stitch. If you are interested in any of my Pokemon patterns that I have made, they are available on my Etsy. And I also, was the hoop record broken? No, I think we're still, we finished three tonight. We finished three tonight. So if you would like any of my patterns, they're available on my Etsy, and they're also available through my Patreon. So if you want more than just like a couple of patterns, I definitely recommend checking out my Patreon. I have a few different tiers on there. I have a $7 tier, which gets you 2 brand new patterns every single month. I have the $12 tier, which gets you access to my entire Pokemon pattern library. Right now, I think I have 36 patterns up there. I add at least 4 new ones every month to the library. This month, I added 5, and next month, surprise for all of you who are already subscribed to the library tier, I will actually be adding at least 5 next month as well. But I promise to make at least 4 every month for that tier. I also have a $50 tier, which I will send you a kit every month that includes all the stuff you need to make your own Pokemon hoop. So it comes with the hoop and the cloth and the DMC floss, the pattern, all the stuff you need like that. It comes with the backing materials, including a piece of felt too. So like I stitch my pieces shut like this, but I also include in my kits a piece of felt that you can hot glue or stitch onto the back of this so that the back of your piece is fully enclosed. I don't do that on my personal pieces because I don't bother. But for the kits that I put together, I do include that. If you do not want to be a part of the Kit of the Month Club on Patreon, I do also sell kits through my Etsy shop. And you can just tell me which one that you would like me to make as a kit for you and send out. So for your first month at the Patreon kit, or if you're buying a kit through my Etsy shop, I also include a needle and a needle minder. as part of your first kit or as part of the kits through my Etsy shop. So things like that. If you would like to hang out with me outside of live stream times, I live stream on TikTok and Twitch 2 days a week on Wednesdays and Sundays from 7:30 Eastern time to about 10:30 Eastern time. If you would like to hang out with me outside of that time, I do have a public Discord server. We started as a TTRPG server playing like Dungeons and Dragons and stuff like that, but we actually have a pretty robust cross section as well because there's a lot of that's a Venn diagram with a lot of crossover, guys. So we post pictures of what we're working on and when we finish stuff and we cheer each other on. We also run a self-care challenge every month and the winners get to have a game night with me. So actually last night was the game night for the winners from February and we played Jackbox for a few hours. So that was really fun. If you are part of my Patreon, I also have a public or a private patrons only Discord where I do streaming of when I'm actually building out my patterns and you get like direct access to ask me questions or like private polls and like stuff like that. So if that's something you're interested in, you have to just be at one of my Patreon level tiers. Doesn't matter which one, all of my patrons get access to the patron Discord. And if I hit, once I get to 20 patrons, I will also start hosting like regular craft nights over there where we can all like live stream together and like hang out together and craft together and stuff like that. So we're not quite there yet. I think we're at 12 right now, but we're getting there. It's one new person at a time, you know? If you have any interest in any of the stuff that I personally use, like what my favorite brand of Ida cloth is or floss is, the craft stand that I use, the needle minders, things like that, I am working on putting together a list of like, here's all the stuff that I use because I know a lot of people like to find out like, oh, what is it that you use type of question. So I am working on that. It crashed when I was trying to build it the other day. So I kind of had to start from scratch. But I am working on putting it together. In the meantime, this craft stand is linked in my bio, but nothing else is yet. If you would like a recap or you would like to watch this live stream again after the fact, I do upload the Twitch live stream onto YouTube about 24 to 48 hours after the stream is over. So if you wanted to see like the walkthrough tutorial of how I do the stitched method or the E6000 super glue method that I did earlier, I do have you'll have access to those. I am trying to work on a video tutorial series here on TikTok as well. It is going slow because mental health and lots of doctor's appointments. I literally have had like 2 to 3 doctor's appointments every week for the past few weeks, and I continue to have more the next few weeks. So that's kind of eating into most of my spare energy at the moment. But that being said, I do also have an Instagram. Like, I literally just post like project updates and like the flowers outside and pictures of my cats. So it's nothing special, but I have that if you want to follow me on Instagram. Anyway, thank you all so freaking much for hanging out with me tonight. It is so much fun. I love stream nights. They're one of my favorite nights of the week. And I love getting to share all of this with you and spend time with all of you. So thank you so much. And I love you all. Good night, my goblin family. And go forth and sow chaos and craft. I'll talk to you later. I will see you, what is today? Today's Wednesday. I'll see you on Sunday.